The sun, our far-off fiery ball of warmth and light. Our life-bringer, our everything. Our Earth orbits the sun like a star-struck lover, but it is a very needy relationship. We need constant attention from the sun, if not, things would get ugly. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that loves Cthulhu as much as we love space. The channel that likes to delve deep into black holes as well as into the inner workings of Jake Paul's love life. Why? Because curious minds aren't limited to just one genre, and no question is ever too stupid. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, what if the sun went out for 24 hours? Before we get into this video, I want to ask you guys to hit that thumbs up button and share this video with a friend. Also, why don't you tell me your favorite kind of weather? It's snowing in Toronto right now, and I'm pretty gutted as my preferred weather is sunny and 25 degrees Celsius. I don't mind rain if I'm amid nature, like the Highlands of Scotland, but rain in the city is the worst. Cool, my British weather chat is on form today. Should we just make this video about that? No? Okay then, onwards. So, the sun. While the sun seems endless, eternal, the only constant in our ramshackled, chaotic lives, actually, it isn't as endless as you might like to think. Honey is gonna be out of here in a few billion years, although we don't really need to worry about that right now. Nor do we need to worry about the sun going out for 24 hours, because that simply isn't gonna happen. But we do love a bit of curiosity, and we wouldn't let a thing like overwhelming probability get in the way of us asking a question. The sun has a profound effect on the Earth from 93 million miles away. It takes 8.5 minutes for sunlight to reach planet Earth, so we wouldn't realize anything was wrong for that period of time. Again, if it miraculously switched back on, we wouldn't feel the effects for the same period. The sun isn't a light switch that you can switch on and off, or a magic act that involves appearing and disappearing, and even if it was, ever pushing that switch would cause total chaos for Earth and the rest of the planets in the solar system. If the sun was out for 24 hours, sure, Earth would get a little bit colder, but nothing a little heating and a few coats couldn't fix, thanks to our atmosphere keeping us toasty. And sure, it would be dark, but electricity in theory would still work. There would be no visible moon, as there would be no sun to reflect light, and for once in the moon's life, there would be no dark side. It would all be dark. The moon doesn't have an atmosphere like us, so temperatures up there would plummet. Luckily, at the moment, there aren't any humans living their best moon lives, but if the sun turned off for 24 hours at a time that we did have a moon station, those humans would likely freeze. While we wouldn't see the moon in our 24-hour-long dark sky, we would, however, see stars. Stars are other suns, lucky enough to still be shining. We would also see crazy auroras in the sky, like the northern lights, but all over. This would be because the lack of sun would create disturbances in the Earth's ionosphere and magnetic field. Pretty, yes. Chaotic? Also yes. The change in electromagnetics would disturb our satellites and our electrical grid. Without light and disturbed electronics and communications, I can imagine that the world would be pretty panicked. Psychologically speaking, if the sun goes out for a day, it would mean total chaos for humans and animals alike. Assuming we didn't know it was going out and how long it was going to be out for, people would start losing it. Like, literally losing it. Dark at 1 p.m? Just as dark at 7 p.m? What is this? Some would turn to looting and roads would be chaos, flights would be cancelled. Oh, and can you imagine the religious groups? They would be citing an end of days, and you know what? Maybe they wouldn't be wrong. Repent or go to hell, although to be honest, Earth would basically be hell, so what's the difference? There would also likely be mass suicides, and when the light turned back on again in 24 hours, where would we find ourselves then? Pretty embarrassed, I think. There is a little detail that I'm missing out, and it isn't a good one. If the light simply turned off for 24 hours, other than social chaos, we actually would be fine. But if the sun as an entity disappeared for 24 hours, we would not be fine at all. The Earth orbits the sun at around 18.5 miles a second, that's 67,000 miles an hour. If the sun disappeared, we would lose the center of our orbit. A lot of people use the analogy of a spherical stone on a string. If we swung it around us fast, that would be a lot like the Earth orbiting the sun. If we suddenly let go of the string, that's basically what would happen if the sun let go of us by disappearing. We would swing off at 67,000 miles an hour in a straight line. We would be knocked out of orbit, but we wouldn't be the only ones. No, it wouldn't just be us. It would also be all the other planets in our solar system and all of their moons, and all of the space rocks around us. While we may not smash into other planets in 24 hours, when the sun comes back and we are all inevitably sucked back into its orbit, things just wouldn't be the same as they were before. Our alignment would be out of kilter, which could very well cause a planetary smash. It would also likely knock the Earth out of its habitable zone. Right now, where we are is perfect for life, but if we were any closer, it would be too hot like Venus, or too cold like Mars. This inevitably would lead to mass extinction, which, you know, would basically suck. So Sun, stay with us! We need you! We love you! Yes, in 1.1 billion years the Sun will begin its end of life cycle, but that is quite an amount of time to create a contingency plan. Until then, let us survive and thrive under its glorious rays. So guys, thank you for watching this video. What would you do if the Sun disappeared for 24 hours? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, let me know your favourite weather states. I love weather chats. Also, while you're down there, why don't you like this video and share it with a friend? And if you guys want to connect with me on social media, there is a link to my Instagram in the description box. Thank you guys for tuning into this answer. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.